Hey yo, welcome to Channel Fireball, and today we have some power rankings. Milwaukee Regionals has just happened, and we've got NAIC, which is going to be the biggest event of the year, coming up this weekend. So let's have a look at what did well and what everyone's playing online. So coming in at number 5, we have Braden Elfoot's Arceus Duraludon deck, and this is actually a deck that took home Milwaukee Regionals, and that's why it's going to be hit number 5. Might not have had the greatest of showings, but it did super well. Duraludon VMAX is a VMAX Pokemon with 330 HP with that really good ability Skyscraper, which means it cannot be hit by any Pokemon that have special energies attached. This is one of those cards that always goes under the radar and people think it's not competitive, but then it always kind of does well occasionally, you know what I mean? Its attack is usable for fighting metal, 220 damage, and it goes through all effects. So if you're hitting something like a Decidueye, you just shred it. Now, there are some cool things about this list. Obviously, we are using Arceus V-Star to accelerate energy to our Duraludons. Obviously, for free energy, you do Trinity Nova, which does 200 damage and accelerates 3 basic energy from your deck to your V Pokemon. So the idea is, between Arceus V-Star, Starbuff and Trinity Nova, you can get your first Duraludon, your opponent knocks out the Arceus, you then go for a Duraludon, and then probably they might not even knock out that Duraludon, but if they do, you then send up the next one when your opponent's only got 5, when your opponent's taking 5 prize cards, and say, you might have had the resources to do it with 1 V-Star and a V-Mask, but you ain't dealing with this one. One of the cool additions in this list was the Eldegoss V with that happy match ability, which when you bench it, lets you get a support back from your discard pile and put it back into your hand. This means we can reuse some of the supporters that we see here, such as the Bird Keeper, which acts as a retreat, a way to maneuver your Pokemon and draw some cards. We've got the one copy of Single Strike Mustard there, so you could potentially use that again. Or we've got Boss, Marnie and Research, all pretty cool cards in this archetype. One thing I do want to turn your attention to is all the healing in this deck, because obviously we want the Duraludons to never go down. So you can already see the two big charms giving your Duraludon 360 HP, which is monstrous. We see the Crystal Cave, which lets you heal 30 off your Metal and Dragon type, so that's some good healing. And then we actually see the two of Hyper Potions as well, which lets you discard 2 energy from a Pokemon, then you heal 120 damage. Now, that seems rather counterproductive in a deck where your Pokemon attacks for 3 colored energy. However, you can always just attach an extra double turbo energy, heal, and then discard the double turbo. Very efficient. And apart from that, we're just trying to make this list as consistent as possible with Ultra Balls and Poke Gear. And honestly, it's a deck that myself, I must not lie, I have slept on a little bit, but hey, if it's winning a regional, you've got to take it seriously. One thing I want to note before we move on as well, having the 4 stadium count super important, so you can counter Path to the Peak. So obviously Path to the Peak will turn off your Skyscraper, which means Pokemon that has special energy can hit into you. We don't want that. So yeah, that's our number 5 deck. What's at number 4? Coming in at number 4 is actually Blissey Miltank, a deck we've always seen dotting around the lower end of the power rankings, but here it actually got 2nd at Milwaukee Regionals via Connor Lavelle's list. It's actually got some cool stuff in it, so let's have a look. Blissey V is a basic Pokemon, 250 HP, oh my goodness, with the Blissful Blast attack, which does 10 damage plus 30 for each energy attached to this Pokemon. After you've calculated your damage, you can get 3 energy cards from your discard pile attached to this Pokemon. So Blissey can start hitting fast real quick, because obviously you get to make use of double turbo energy, which actually counts as 2 powerful energy, which counts which gives you an extra 20, so that's like plus 50 for each powerful energy and all that good stuff. Now, Astral Radiance did give the Blissey deck some new toys, such as the Radiant Greninja, which lets you discard an energy card and then draw 2 cards, which is perfect for Blissey, because not only do you get to draw cards, but you get to get energy in the discard pile that you can just sling up to your Blissey. We've also got Miltank here, which can work with all the energies that Blissey can, but it's also immune to V Pokemon damage. So if your opponent gets a little bit too crazy, you can start to use Miltank to take some prizes. Now, worth noting, Blissey's 250 HP basic Pokemon, so if you put a Cable of Toughness on there, you actually get to 300 HP, which is rather crazy. And we get to see some healing in this list as well. Let me just move myself out of the way so you can see that. 4 Hyper Potions. So we saw them in Duraludon already. We've got 4 copies of it here. And again, discarding 2 energy really doesn't matter, because you get to just fling them straight back into play. We've even got a couple of the Switch Cart, which lets you switch your basic active Pokemon and then heal 30 damage from that. We've got 2 Team Yell towels there, which heal 50 from both Pokemon. And then we've obviously got the one copy of Cherin's Cares. So it says you get back a colourless Pokemon and put it straight back in your hand. But however, there was some real cool fun stuff in I want to turn your attention to, such as this Tornadus, which is really good because in a lot of people will try and tech against Blissey Miltank by using something like Flying Pikachu, which it's immune to basic Pokemon damage. However, what this Tornadus does, when you bench it, it's like an escape rope, your opponent has to swap their active. So what you can do is build up a huge Blissey that's capable of one-shotting these Pokemon, then you use Tornadus, push it to the bench, combine it with one of your four copies of Battle's Orders, bring it back, and then give it a good hard slap. That's the idea. As you can see, there are four copies of Barsigmi Super Aggressive. Four copies of Patter the Peak as well, because Blissey's ability lets you remove special conditions. Honestly, not that important. So four Patter the Peak will help slow down your opponent. You'll turn the stuff off like Genesex and Arceus V-Stars as well. One cool card for this deck is the Roxanne, which when your opponent has three prize cards or less, you can make them shuffle their hand in and they only get two cards and then you get seven. So yeah. Also get the Avery to be a real good disruption card, which makes your opponent discard till they have three cards on their bench. Again, just being a super irritant. Speaking of irritants, we've also got the Yveltal, which for a DTE discards three special energies from your opponent. Not only just good against Mew, but your kids could be good against all other special energy decks as well. And then worth noting, you've got Dunsparce, so you can remove your weakness. Honestly, Blissey Miltank, I thought it was a meme, but it's definitely here to stay since it got to the final of Milwaukee. But what's at number three? Coming in at number three is Justin Coolus with his Arceus Inteleon deck. A deck which I thought actually would start to fall further down the rankings than what it has, but I guess it's so fundamentally sound, it's going to be around for a long time. We've already talked about Arceus V-Star, but here is pretty much our only attacker. All we do is attack with Arceus. There could be other Pokemon you want to attack with, like maybe with a Starmie, but Justin was like, you know what? I'm just going to use Arceus and pair it with the Inteleon engine, with the Drizzards letting you grab a trainer from the deck when you evolve them, and then the Big Shade Dealers letting you get two trainers and then one copy of the Quick Shooting, which puts two damage counters on your opponent's Pokemon once per turn. So you can see this is like a real good fundamentally strong deck. You've got the Dunsparce to remove weakness and the Manaphy to prevent bench damage as well. Combo all that with your consistent engine with two copies of Cherin's Care, meaning that if your Arceus tanks a hit, which it should do, especially with two copies of Big Charm, you can just put it all back into your hand and start attacking with the next one. And that's the idea, using a big, strong, tanky two prizer as your only attacker and try and seal the game up from there. Obviously, you've got some copies of supporters as well, such as Melanie, which I love in Arceus decks, because what the Melanie does, if you miss energy turn one, normally you can never really get to the Nova turn two. However, Melanie makes that happen in combination with Starbirth, which lets you get two cards from your deck once per game. Honestly, Starbirth's pretty insane. Apart from that, the deck is pretty disruptive in the sense that you've got two copies of Path to the Peak and one copy of Collapse Stadium. Path to the Peak can stop your opponent's Starbursts and Genesex, and then Collapse Stadium can also be annoying, making both players only have four bench Pokemon. However, Collapse Stadium is probably just to be more of an out to your opponent's Path to the Peak. Got the Power Pad, got the Ordinary Rod, and apart from that, the list is fairly simple and straightforward. But that's not to say that Arceus and Inteleon, just because it's simple and straightforward, is not strong. It is an incredibly strong deck, which I thought would tail off in the Astral Radiance format. However, it's still knocking about at number three. But what's going to be at number two? So coming in at our second most played deck, we have Mew VMAX. And this list comes courtesy of Chris Nugvid, who got top four at Milwaukee. Well done to you. Mew VMAX again is a deck that many people thought would start to tail off. However, it is still really strong. Cross Fusion Strike from the Mew VMAX, letting you copy any one of your Fusion Strike Pokemon's attack. The one you use mostly is Genesex 210 Techno Blast attack. However, you can also use Meloetta, which does 70 for each Fusion Strike energy you have in play. If you have four Fusion Strike energies in play, that means you can do 280 damage, and all you got to do then is have a choice belt or a tablet. You're now hitting for 300 damage upwards, which just ejects anything from the game. And that's obviously not too hard to do, because Alisa Sparkle gets two Fusion Energies from the deck, meaning you can use an Alisa to get two in play, then attach one more, and you're at three energies in play. Turn one, go in second, which means you can even attack with the Meloetta in that instance and try and get some donks on some V Pokemon. Genesect also lets you draw up to the amount of Fusion Strike Pokemon you have in play. So if you have 6 Fusion Strike Energy Pokemon in play and a 0 card hand, you get to draw 6 cards and that stacks. So if you have 3 Gen sets, you get to use 3 of those abilities. Honestly, it's pretty crazy. One cool addition that Mew does get now though is the Trekking Shoes, which lets you look at the top card of your deck. If you like it, put it in your hand. If you don't, just discard it and then draw the next card. So it's always a +1 from the deck and it has a little bit of discard synergy as well. So what's not to like? You know, you got the VIP battle passes so you can set up the board on your first turn. Chromatics, which is like computer search on a coin flip. Roam Phone. Worth noting here that there are no catchers. Now, Mew tended to play catchers in Milwaukee and slightly before Milwaukee as well. However, Chris decided not to play catchers here. So that's up to you. Catchers are obviously a really powerful card when you flip heads, basically bosses orders on a coin flip. However, if you flip tails, it's kind of a waste. So I can see why you would and why you wouldn't play it. However, Chris is super well here, getting a top 4. So what's our number one pick? The coming at number one should be no surprise, Palkia V-Star, with 3 top 8s this week. A little bit down from the 8 top 8s in Australia, but hey, it's still super strong. Here we have Tord Redcliffe, who got top 8 at the event. Palkia V-Star with its subspace well attack, 60 plus 20 for each bench Pokemon you have in play, adds up really fast. And then with its V-Star power, letting you get 3 water energies from your discard pile and attach them to your Pokemon any way you like. What this means is, number one, your early turn fighting energy isn't that important because you just fling them into play. But this also lets you use some alternate attackers, as and we can see some here, such as Starmie V, which does 50 times each energy attached to your opponent's Pokemon. So that means if an Arceus has used a Trinity Nova, Starmie just comes in and starts slapping stuff around. And not only can you use this Starmie via Melanie, because it only attacks with 2 energy, you can actually just use it with the Palkia V-Star's attack power as well. Not only that, but we can actually attack with Radiant Greninja. Like we said earlier, it lets you discard energy to draw 2 cards, which is perfect for Palkia. But it also has, for 3 energy, a 90-90 snipe. This is crazy, considering you can just start KOing bench Drizzles and Sobbles and anything like this, making Manaphy a real big include in a lot of decks, because if you don't, Greninja can just start to get to work. One cool card that we also saw in here that Tor played was the Lumineon V, which when you bench it, lets you grab a supporter from the deck. Don't mind that, pretty cool card to have in your deck. And yeah, we see the thin Inteleon line here with 1 Shady Dealings and 1 Quick Shooting in combination with 2 Nets. One thing I like about Palkia is the amount of cool situational cards you can play, as we see the Iridas here, which lets you get 1 water Pokemon and an item. Super strong, never a bad supporter to have. You've got the Manny for energy acceleration, and you get 1 water energy from the discard pile and draw 3. We got 1 Shovel, which heals all damage from your evolution Pokemon and lets make you discard. The Rock Sand, which we've mentioned before for some real good disruption. The Nisa, which lets you get back in comp 5 with any combination of water energies and Pokemon. Pretty good for recovery. 2 boss. And one thing I really like is the split of stadiums. One path to the peak to turn off your opponent's your wall box Pokemon abilities. And then Temple of Sinnoh, making it so where all special energies only count for colorless. Palkia V-Star is here to stay, and if you're going to any events or league, you have to have a game plan against Palkia. And if it's not a good game plan, you might have to consider playing Palkia instead. Let me know what you think. If you want to buy any of these cards, do it from Channel Fireball and use my code HotChalk. It'll help me out and it helps you out as well. Okay, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.